So in today's lecture, we will discuss about photocopier. So, all of you use the photocopy machine for taking the Xerox. So we will discuss about the working principle, the construction, and what are the various steps which are required for making the photocopy of any paper. So here, first you will see the historical background of this photocopier. In USA, there was a person and his name was Carlson. Chester Carlson, actually, was Chester. So Chester Carlson, one person was there in New York of US. This man, basically, he was involved as a patent attorney, right? So he was working in patent office in New York, and he helped the people who want to register their invention as a patent. So during that process, he has to make large number of photocopies, right? Duplicate papers. He has to make a lot of duplicate papers, and that was a tedious job for him. So he decided to make one machine, and by that machine he wanted to generate the photocopies, right? So he tried, and finally he manufactured one machine, and that machine he manufactured in 1938, right? And he gave the name to that machine as xerography. Okay. So xerography is the combination of basically two words. One is zero and another is graphy. So xerography is a basically Latin word. Xero means writing. Xero means dry. And graphy means writing. So xerography means dry writing. So he invented a machine which can be used for dry writing purpose and for making multiple copies. Now after inventing this machine, he registered one patent for this machine, and after that he approached many companies to sell this idea, right? Even he approached IBM also, right? But at that time, those big companies and even IBM, they were unable to understand that people may require that many number of photocopies. So they never purchased that idea, and they never manufactured those type of machines commercially. So finally this person, Carlson, he contacted one NGO, non-profit organization, and he explained his idea to that particular non-profit organization. Then the non-profit organization company and Carlson, they contacted one company at that time, and that company agreed to manufacture this photocopy machine, right? And in 1950, right, first commercial, so this first first commercial photocopy machine was manufactured, right, and this machine came in the market in 1950. So this machine came in the market by a company, Haloid Corporation. So, Haloid Corporation, they manufacture first commercial photocopy machine, and they this company gave name to that photocopy machine as Xerox machine. Xerox machine, right? So, that photocopy machine became a huge hit in the market. And then, and finally, the Haloid Corporation changed its name from Haloid to Xerox Corporation, right? Xerox Corporation, due to the huge success of this photocopy machine. So this is the history of the Xerox machine, how it came in the market. Now we will see the working principle of this photocopy machine. So, working principle. So, photocopier basically works with the help of two principles. One, principle of photoconductivity. And second, Coulomb's law. These are two principles on basis of which the photocopier works. So the photoconductivity, it is the property of a material whose conductivity rises with the exposure of light, right? So in photoconductivity, it is a property in which the conductivity of material rises with the exposure of light, right? And this type of property you can find in semiconductors. So, when in our first lecture, when we discussed about the resistive sensor, at that time we discussed about this photoconductivity principle also, right? Where the conductivity of the semiconductor, how the conductivity rises with the exposure of light. Now, the Coulomb's law, it states that like charges repel and unlike charges attract. So this is the basic principle of Coulomb's law. So a photocopier basically works on these two principles. Now we will see the construction of this photocopier machine. construction. So there is one glass plate. So there is one glass plate. So this is glass plate. So whatever means photocopy we want to take for of some paper, so that printing material has to be placed on this glass plate in such a way that the printing material should be in contact with this glass plate. And once we will place that page here over the glass plate, then over that page we will place one plastic sheet. Now here there is one optical system. So this is one optical system. And in this optical system there are few mirrors and few lenses are there. Right? So in this optical system there is mirrors and lens. Now just below this optical system there is one aluminium drum, right? So there is one aluminium drum. So this is aluminium drum. And over this aluminium drum, a coating of selenium material is done. So aluminium drum with coating of selenium. Now this aluminium drum, now next to this aluminium drum there is a development tank, right? So this is inside this development tank, there is a magnetic roller. This is magnetic roller. And this magnetic roller and this aluminium drum, they rotates in opposite direction. So if aluminium drum is rotating in this direction, so magnetic roller will rotate in this direction. And in this development tank there is toner. Toner is there. So this toner consists of black color powder, and that powder is used for the printing of the text. Right? Now here so this is the part from where the plain paper will come. Plain paper will enter from this side, and the text which we want to photocopy, that text will be printed over this plain paper. Right? Plain paper. Now this plain paper will go to one chamber, and this is a heating chamber. This is the heating chamber, and finally we will get final photo. Okay. So this is the whole arrangement which is required for a photocopying machine. Right? So here we have glass plate. This is transparent, right? Transparent. And over this we will put one plastic cover. Right? Plastic cover is there. So whatever page we want to make a photocopy, that page we will keep over this transparent glass plate in such a way the printed text, right? The printed text will be in touch with this glass plate. Okay? And there is one light source. This is my light source. That light source will scan the printed paper. Okay? And after scanning, the light will fall over this mirror. Right? And from the mirror it will be reflected, and it will go through the various lenses, and finally again it will fall over this mirror, and from here it will go to this aluminium drum. It will fall over the aluminium drum. Now, in the aluminium drum, we have done a coating of selenium, which is a photoconductive material, right? So, the printed text will be printed over this selenium, and there is one development tank. From the development tank, the toner, which is a black color powder, it will be used for the printing of the required text, right? And finally, whatever thing is to be printed, it will be printed over plain paper, and it will go to the heating chamber, and finally we will get a photocopy. So in next lecture, we will discuss about the various steps which is required for photocopy.